Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. This is a very special video for my those viewers who want to repair some circuit board and we cannot find any service manual, any circuit diagram, any schematic or any documentation about that board. Most of the time the companies are not providing service manual for that board. For example, it is 4 ton or 5 ton LG inverter air conditioner. No documentation, no circuit diagram is available there. If we want to search any service manual, how we can find it? There is a sticker here. This sticker for specially this model number. Here is EBR number. EBR 7857 whatsoever. Check the number on that sticker. If you will find any circuit diagram that will be exactly for this board. Then we have PWB printed wiring board number EAX649137 and assembly EBR 758794. We can try these three numbers from the Google, from any browser, to find datasheet, service manual with different keywords. For example, if you cannot find this number on Google, might be we can find this number. What will the difference? Might be this board here, it is being used in 4-ton air conditioner. And if we find any service manual, any circuit diagram against this number EAX649137 or EBR number whatsoever, might be it is being used in LG 5 ton in some conditions, the same board. I will give just example. The same number, it is being used in sharp, the assembly number. Maybe it is also used in Kenwood, maybe it is also used in Airwell, because this board is simple electronic kit. When it becomes special, when this software is written here in these two software ICs, in EEPROM and in the microcontroller, then it becomes unique for that assembly. At that time might be the 4-ton unit will not work in 5-ton. Why? Because the coding here, the communication and all the controls, components locations, these are being addressed through the software code. We can find this number or second these numbers. If we cannot find anything at all, not for specially inverter AC, any type of circuit, either it is power supply, either it is washing machine board, either it is welding machine, whatsoever, we will make a block diagram and we will write the numbers of the main ICs, how they are located in the board. For example, here is current sense IC, here is STR power converter, then here microcontroller, microprocessor, microcomputer, then EEPROM, then here is Darlington driver, IGBT driver, IPM, bridge rectifier, and these IGBT modules. When we will make block diagram and then we will download data sheet for each IC. In that data sheet we can find sample circuit for this IC, sample circuit for this IC, typical application or sample circuit for this IC. That will help us to understand, I can say 95% exactly the similar function. Might be in the data sheet it will show just only one output of this SMPS circuit, that is STR 3A155 but practically maybe it is giving 4 outputs. We have no concern with the outputs, because outputs are required for different circuits within this board. We need control circuits. Then we can understand the microcontroller. What are the input and output ports? If here is using any optocoupler, we can see what is the configuration of that optocoupler. Either it is for input or output. Then memory IC, it is the same. Then we can understand the function of this current sense IC. Let's start. I will move this board to microscope. Here is the first IC, 3A155D. 3A155D. ACS710T. A20114. Then closer to A02114, this is fan 3227C. It is KID 55004. Then we have microcontroller. I need to remove the sticker. Under this software code sticker, there will be part number of this microcontroller. I will also remove the sticker from this IC and we will check it. It is MA358. In this area, 358 MA. And in the rear side, we have bridge rectifier, then we have 2 IGBT, then we have IPM. To find the part number of this IPM, we need to remove it. And we can find part number for this IGBT. IGBT is 40N60 FGAF. Bridge rectifier is KBJ5010. Then we have rectifier here, ETH3006FP. MCU, memory, and here are optocouplers. 1, 2, 3, and 4th one for power supply. Now we can see this optocoupler, pin 1 is here. Its pin 1 is in this side. So LED side is here. It is for reception mode. And this is for transmission, because its collector transistor is in output side. And its LED is here, LF48. All 3 optocouplers are with same number. And if you see, it is also in reception mode. Its LED is closer to this connector. That means it will receive some command. It will deal with any control, from external control to power it on for any purpose. And this is for communication. Let's see the data sheet on the internet. Now we will download data sheet for 3A155D data sheet. Open this alldatasheet.com in new tab. PWM offline switcher regulator IC. Download 5739. It is given code to download. Now if you see first IC, that means it is receiving line voltage here in the bridge rectifier, its rectifier circuit, and then it will convert these voltage. It is working like a very simple converter IC as a flyback. We will discuss this circuit in detail. Now we will check the second IC. A20114. It is continuous conduction mode interleaving PFC control IC. Download 62316 download. So this is PFC control IC. It will maintain the voltage on DC rail. So our this IC will create signals and then it will drive IGBT driver, and we will receive drive signal on the IGBTs and it will maintain the voltage. Next IC, FAN 3227, FAN 3227, dual 2 ampere high speed low side gate driver. We will download data sheet from here. 54599. It is much better that if you find service manual, that's good, but if we cannot find, then we need to do this process. This is FAN 3227. We will discuss in detail every section and with possible approaches to test, troubleshoot and repair. Then the next IC, KID 65004. Download. Yes, it is exactly ULN 2004. It is dual low power operation amplifier. Then we have ACS710. ACS710T. We can see ACS710, it is current sense IC. It will sense the total current and it will provide relative signal to that current value. What is the current flow in the circuit? It will measure and it will inform to the microcontroller and for other applications to make soft start. This time I am not downloading datasheet for microcontroller and memory because I did not remove the stickers. I will remove the stickers and we will download its datasheet and we will discuss each section separately with full details. By combining these pieces to our block diagram, and we can understand the function, how that circuit is working. If we see the first IC, it is to provide power. Then the role of this IC, ACS710, it is current sense circuit. This is operation amplifier, that means it will provide some amplification to weak signals. And this is Darlington transistor array. Then we have IGBT gate driver and we have PFC controller. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.